them all in wheelchairs and stretch them out.
Thank you. What?
I just kind of did it twice to people. Like, hey, you see what I did?
I added more rules.
They're gonna be good.
Yeah.
You know, the really awful thing about the two.
Oh.
He's waiting until his pension vests at 30 years or something so he can get more money when he retires.
So he's not going yet.
June or July? But he should announce now that he's going to step down in August. Say, well,
oh.
You know, he should announce now, well, you know, it's time for me to retire. New leadership is going to take a while to transition. We're looking for a new chief. I'm going
to
stay through August 1st.
That would be the smart way to do it.
That would be the smart way to do it. And then, you know, we know that the chief is going, you know, because the mayor's not going to fire him. Edley is not going to fire him before he vests for his pension.
He's fired anybody before. Why would he fire him?
Yeah. They're not going to do it.
Yeah.
So, at least I don't think so.
I could be wrong.
But he could announce now. He's been there 5 years. That's longer than most chiefs last. You know, that's a long tenure for a police chief.
With a bad history, that's very long.
Yeah, and he can say, I've tried in 5 years, time to move mud, my pension comes due, his wife's pension comes due around the same time, retire, and I'll stay on through the transition period.
Yeah.
And then basically, the mayor will let him sit there.
We've got to
put control in the hands of somebody else and sort of just sit there behind a desk for 3 months and collect a pension. Which is a bogus thing to do, but nevertheless, to get him out of there. You know, someone's got to be accountable for something. That's the whole thing.
So far, not many of them are.
No, that's what, you know. Listen, the problem with firing Chief Suhr is there's nobody better than Rex. It's not like there's some really great progressive.
Well, we've been hearing about all the actions they've been going on in the police. I mean, there is nothing...
Right.
Like,
so
if he left, who else is going to take over?
It's not as if there's, like, deputy chiefs or assistant chiefs or command staff people or even captains who are so great that you want them in place. On the other hand, it sends a message of accountability. I mean, someone's got to be...
But the other thing, I don't think they want to give people hope that they have a power.
I know.
That's the other thing. That's a really big one.
You know what people think you're marching?
It's like, oh, you're marching, we're going to step down.
We're gonna find you, 'cause we're firman dos líneas. Firman dos líneas, uno al otro lado.
Thank you. tell them that the demand is here. Out of respect, we have an elderly mother, and we have six hunger strikers. He did try to see them the other day, and the mother said she wants to meet him at his office, and she came 2 miles on wheelchair to be here. If the mayor's in Bayview, which is not Brazil or Mexico, he can come here in 10 minutes or 20 minutes and meet them. Can you find out if that can be done?
Just call him.
Call him.
The baby was here.
Yeah, really.
Somebody is going to...
Probably.
Don't you want to meet with the mayor? They're going to call the mayor now. There's a board of supervisors meeting for Daniel. Did we ask, did we find out the board, are they meeting?
Yes.
They're shut down.
Okay, the board of supervisors is in session.
Let's
go. Someone, you want to tell the people from downstairs to come up?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, do you want to?
Come on through.
For life. We won't do it.
We need real people. Stop. Y'all.
Oh, because you're from the community.
Good job.
What happened? What happened? What happened to you? If you can act like you're with the community by day and be downtown cutting deals by night,
woo,
the mayor does not deserve your silence.
Nope.
Get up and be real men and
women. Work with the police commission on the corner. That's
my
fault. That's right.
Privately, but I warned you that this day is coming, and we'll be back in a few days.
That's right.
With double the number.
That's
yeah.
Right.
That's
it's
right.
Not going
it's
away.
Right,
now, the question is, what do you want your legacy to be? As a sellout that can't even go among your people?
Number
or
eight.
As somebody that stands with your people? This is supposed to be the people's house. Stand and represent the people. The people are here.
Power of the people!
What more would you like us to do?
Please.
What are you talking about?
No, no, no.
People.
So, I am here to tell you that
equip those people.
They're just fucking there out of love. They call my team. We're going to look here.
Department's been in reform. You don't find a whole lot because I've been following all 30 years. The police department today ain't no different than it was 10 years ago. Alex Nieto died 2 years and 2 months ago. What reform has been done in the last 2 years and 2 months?
That was
terrible.
Trick word.
Where did you born?
Trick word.
In fact, right after Alex Nieto died, Perez got killed. And supposedly, it was his fault. But there was an autopsy. Everybody seen the autopsy report? Have you seen the autopsy report? Have you seen your report? Have you ever seen the No?
Wow. How much money has the city paid paying off these cops' crime?
How do you think we feel? How do you
something that the state attorney general could initiate tomorrow. Okay. Since you called for independent investigation, the Department of Justice disrespected your call and sent cops out here, which was not an independent investigation. You know it, but the problem is you allowed it to happen, and you all have not taken a collective stance. Now we're saying, since this department cannot, will not reform itself. And somebody said earlier, Supervisor Combs, you know, don't lecture us. I'm the president of the African American Community Police Relations Board. I've been trying to reform this department for nearly 15 years.
That's the legend.
And you were a police commissioner. I don't need the education. It comes from, you know, Bull Connor wasn't going to change. George Wallace wasn't going to change. You all sound pathetic when you allow hard-hearted people in power to tell you what they're not going to do. History is replete with examples of people who said they weren't going to change, and now they're out of power. The question is, do we have men and women of some courage that are willing to take a principled stand? If you can't take a public position because you've been advised, then take a private position. All of you all together need to go visit your mayor and warn him that all hell is about to break loose on his and your watch. And it would be a damn shame and a crime. And your legacy is in the balance here. People don't believe you.
I saw you.
I support him. He's on our side.
Yes.
Okay. And
Frisco, if you don't remember that address, this is the name of it, all right? Congregation Sharif Israel. Congregation Sharif Israel. All right? So let's get over there. That's over on 2266 California. It's California and Webster. California and Webster, all right? Okay.
Let's give it up for Frisco.
I think this journey has been filled with small victories. It may not feel like it for some of us because a lot of us have been fighting before us and it feels like we're going in circles. And that's what I'm here for. We're passing on the torch to us to keep fighting because we're not going to stop. You know, this is something that we really feel dearly in our hearts. And I think this movement, what's been happening in the last 12, 13 days, is just real magical. And I think a lot of people have felt it. It's not just me, it's not just the so-called Frisco Five, it's the community. And I like to say that it's the community that kept us safe. You know, it's not just us putting our lives on the line. It's the people that's been staying with us all night into the morning to make sure that we're okay. So they're putting their lives on the line just as much as we are. And that's what we all have to do, I believe. That's why this is magical. You got my brothers from the mission over here. You got the Nation of Islam over here. You know, Zulu Nations over here. You got all these brothers of different organizations coming together. And this is like a dream of mine. I know it's a dream of my mother and my brothers to really have the solidarity and the unity so we can take things further and really put pressure on Illicyh. So, yes, we do need to go see Chief Sir and Adachi and let them know that we're not playing. Because today, regardless of what happened, it's a victory and it's historical. We're making history and we're going to change San Francisco. I guarantee you that before I'm going out of here, guys.
Somebody. And that's sad that it takes that much. But we'll be here until Chief Sir steps down, puts his bag back in the box, and nails it back to City Hall.
Yeah.
Because I'm telling you, people are saying, it's not Chief Sir. We understand that. It's step one. This is a movement. There's step two. His name is Ed Lee. There's step three, it's called let's change this police department because it's inherently racist and bigoted and they've shown it to the world and we're not going to stand for it anymore. And we went into the Board of Supervisors and I was sad for what I saw. We had a Board of Supervisors tell us that what we're doing is simplistic, that this is not right, and he actually doesn't support firing Chief Sir. And then he came at us and said, where have you all been? Because I've been working on police reform, and we said, we've been hungry. That's what we've been doing. And our sister Felicia put it on the line and said, none of you have ever put your life on the line for anything that you believe in. And they froze because they knew that she was right. But we're going to continue this hunger strike. Because what just happened was historic. Ed Lee has a black eye. The Board of Supervisors have no idea what to do, and they're going to be scared because Mama and the rest of us have declared that we will be here until our stomach starts eating itself, until the ambulance comes. But I can feel it. I felt something today when we started at 17th of the month, so there's something powerful. The creeks in their shields are getting wider, they're getting thicker. They think that shield was impenetrable, but they've never met SF natives that are willing to fight to the death so we get justice in this city.
We're going to win this game. Now, we had a war ahead of us, right? And we're going to win this game.
I don't think you care about any human being. I mean, you're waiting for the board of supervisors, and we saw the board of supervisors that are supposed to be, but they are black, and they are brown, and, you know, Asian, and all this stuff, you know. They don't care. They really don't care. But now, see, now it's powerful. Because we have shown the world that we were trying to reach out to those who said that are representing our people in there, and they did not respond. So there will be no more negotiations. There will be no more talking to any of these people. There will be only a constant struggle, not only by us that are not going to eat, but each one of you that are going to go and follow the mayor everywhere that he's in, and you tell him that he has to save our life and that he has to fire that chief of police. It is up to you guys. You have to do it. You understand? We are behind the flag, but each one of us can do an action, my lord. Each one of us can take an action. And we can make the difference. We will make the difference. They're laughing about a hunger strike. They're making fun of what we're doing. It's okay. We win it. You saw the people that march here.
Yes.
You saw that unity. So we need to be able to do this. We need you. You need to walk out of classes. You need to go ahead and call the office of Mayor Lee all the time. You need to go into the offices of every single supervisor there and call him a coward and tell them, why haven't you taken an action to, in order to protect the life of these people
right.
that are dying for what is right? You need to do that.
Yeah.
You are guerreros y guerreras. You are war fighters. Somos guerreros y guerreras. Okay? Every single one of us. Somos guerreros. We need to fight for our rights. We need, this is our time. This is our time, and today we won. Yes, we won. Yes, we won. We won. We won because we have our people together, and they will never divide us again. Never again. And we're going to demand what is right and move on and on and on. We are not going to stop this. I told them, and I want you all to know, it is my desire and my wish that these young men quit the hunger strike. It's my desire and wish because they have a lot to do out there. And I have a son, too, that I love dearly. And it is my desire that they respect my wishes to remain in the hunger strike until something happens. Because we had to be willing. We had to be willing to give our life for this. For our children. You understand? Our children. Our children. Woo! Our children. You understand? Our children. Our children. We gotta leave a better future for them. For you. And everything. If you are all we have. We have our bodies, our soul, our heart, and you. You are our tools, our voices. You are the voice that we need outside while we're starving over there. So we count on you. We need you. Do everything that you can. Don't leave this building alone. Don't you ever leave it alone. Come every day, even if it's one or two people, and you make a statement, and you say something, very important. That's how changes are made. Rosa Parks sat down by herself on that bus
right.
and said, I had enough. Gandhi, with a hunger strike, fought for the freedom of his country, alone. Alone, one man, fighting for justice, for equality. But we can all do it. We can all do it. We can all make a difference. Cesar Chavez, also, the hunger strike.
Yep.
In order to create that union.
Yep.
For the workers, the workers in the campus.
Good. Why are you one of the people that
in Ireland,
the
Irish prisoners went on a hunger strike and died fighting for the freedom of their country. Okay? So, here we are, making history, but we need you. I don't want us to die. I don't want to die. I want to go home. I want to eat some good food. I don't even want to talk about that. Yes, we all do. We all do. I want to walk the street happy. I want to kiss my husband. I want to do all those things that you guys are doing there. But this fight has to go on. We cannot quit now. You know that, right? You know that we cannot quit right now. So here we are. Black and brown unity.
Yeah.
Ganamos esta batalla. We won. We won. We chose what kind of people we are and what we stand for. That we were willing to talk, to touch his heart in order to make a difference. And he refused. We won. Because we make the step forward in order to advance, in order for him to understand the needs of our movement. And he didn't care. So we won. We won, and this is our victory, brothers and sisters. The victory of the black and brown people of this city.
The only thing we can say is that we will win. And I want to leave today, and remember, we're on 17th of Valencia. You will find us there because we haven't left there in 13 days. This is the first time I'm exhausted in this city.
Yeah.
So we will leave this city hall step chanting that we will win. We will win.
We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win.
I just want to say one last thing to all of you. They started calling me Mama, and I became Mama. And you know, a mother protects her children. So you gave me a big responsibility. I am humbled because I am accepting that responsibility.
Thank you, Mama.
I am accepting that responsibility.
I got word that the other hundreds of supporters are in the Board of Supervisors meeting. They're in public comment, and every single one of them is telling the Board of Supervisors that they need to fire Chief Suhr. If I can get the fist up one last time, one thing we do, and I'm assuring you, we live with love. We're doing this out of radical love for our people. I'm telling you, there'll be no other reason to do this. And so on three, I would just ask you to scream as loud as you possibly can into the heavens to those that have been killed and say a word for them. One, two, three.
Ahoy!
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.